Hey, what's up guys, Like the Way Setup here, and today I want to show you guys some very useful options, features, and tricks on your iPhone. Now, these are going to be some comments and also some questions that I get on social networks. So let's begin. Now, believe it or not, a lot of people always ask me, how do I know what's taking up storage on my device? And I know a lot of you guys already know how to do this, but if you go to General under the Settings application, and then you go to the Storage and iCloud Usage, right here you have an entire breakdown. The second option right here is going to be your iCloud Usage. It's going to give you all of your devices and how much space they're using on the iCloud per device and also per documents and data. So you have all your notes, your documents, and you can go ahead and tap into any of those, edit them, and also delete them if you wish to do so. That's going to be your iCloud section. Above that, it's going to be your physical storage. It's going to give you the storage that you're taking up. In this case, I'm taking up 6 gigabytes, and the available storage, in this case, I have 245. So this is a 256 gig iPhone. So you can go into manage here, and it gives you a breakdown as well on which applications are taking up the space. In this case, I have iOS 10.3.2 beta 5 that I'm ready to install, but I can go ahead and tap onto there and delete it. That's about 2 gigabytes of storage that's being taken up just with that alone. This happens a lot, by the way. People don't really know they have a software updates lingering in their storage background. They're taking up storage. You also have your Twitter, your photos, and it gives you a breakdown. You can tap into there and delete the application, and you get a better understanding on what's taking up space on your device. Now, also another thing that I wanted to address was here under the album section, you have the recently deleted. Believe it or not, a lot of people delete their photos and forget to delete them from their trash can. It's very similar when you delete something on your computer now on an iPhone. You can delete it, it goes to the trash, then you have to tap into the trash and delete the trash itself as well. So just wanted to address that one because believe it or not, I get that question a lot. The next one I want to share with you guys is how to have a dedicated button on your screen for whatever it is that you want. Go into General, Accessibilities, and right here under the Assistive Touch, you want to enable that. And when you click into the custom tab levels here, you have 6 icons. Well, you can bring this down to 1 and then set a custom gesture. For example, I want to say lock here. So lock the screen. Now, if my power button is broken, I can lock the screen from the screen there by tapping on the Assistive Touch. It doesn't bring me into any additional menus like it normally would if you have several icons. So it's just a 1 single press and then you go to the lock, or it locks your device instead of having to dig through the menus. And you can set any particular action that you wish. So if your home button's going bad, you can have the multitasker there instead. It's very useful for me, especially on some of the devices that the home button doesn't work properly. And on my iPhone 5, the power button doesn't work too well. So Assistive Touch, 1 single tap, you can have any particular action on 1 single shot there on your home screen. So pretty cool stuff. Another very useful option that I get a question a lot is under Accessibilities and Speech. A lot of people want their phone to read things out to them without having to mess around with any bubbles and things on the screen as you normally would with selective text. Well, you have the speech screen. This option here, if you enable it, you can select the speed here for the voice and also select a voice. And if you're reading any content or you have any content on your screen that you want your phone to read it to you, all you have to do is swipe down with 2 fingers from the top. It reads everything out to you. You can speed up, slow down, pause, play, and so on by simply swiping down with 2 fingers and having that option enabled. And talking about reading, I want to also share some information that a lot of you guys were asking me. How do I read an article without having to reload it using data all the time? Especially iPad users ask me this a lot. So say you're traveling, you're not going to have a network connection for a while on your iPad or something like that, but you want to read this article that you have right in front of you. Well, all you have to do is swipe down here, click on the search tab, scroll over, and then save as PDF. What this is going to do is going to save the entire article to your iBooks application. Now, you won't need a network connection to read it later. All you have to do is tap into the article and it goes right then and there without any network connection. So pretty cool stuff as well. You can go ahead and read any article at any time. Another option I get the question a lot is, what's the little triangle up at the top that seems like it's tracking my location constantly? Well, it's easy to find out. Just go to Privacy, Location Services, and right here you can check any application that says always, like right here, weather is always tracking your location station to give you the weather. You can set it to never if it doesn't have the option to while in use. So if it doesn't have that option, then if you don't want it to track you, just say never. I also wanted to go to system and services, because down here we have an option that's called frequent locations. Right here is going to give you a frequent location areas. It tracks where you're going at all times. I highly suggest you turn that off. And what you want to do is go ahead and clear history so that your phone doesn't really know where you're at all times. It's kind of creepy. A lot of people don't know about it. If you don't mind it, I guess that's fine. But to me, it's kind of weird just that my phone knows where I'm at all times. Now, the next one I want to share with you guys, I wouldn't recommend turning it off, but a lot of people were asking me about it as well. So I'm going to show you how to do it. So notifications here, how to turn off amber or emergency alerts. So down here, you have the amber and emergency alerts. Again, I don't recommend turning these off. These are services that are really good to everyone to help out with whatever emergency may be happening. But for those of you who want to disable amber alert or emergency alerts, that's going to be under the notifications tab in setting and scrolling all the way down. Now, this next one is going to be an answer to a question. That is how to get a custom signature on your email. And I'll show you here. If you don't know what that is, you go into the email section and you can scroll all the way down and you'll find signature. Now, you may notice that every time you send an email, it says send from my iPhone. Well, you can tap into there and say you own a business, you want to put your business email address, phone number, things like that. You can do that in this section here, click save, and then every time you send an email, that signature will be going at the bottom of the email every time. You don't have to copy and paste it, so it's very useful. Now, you can also click into accounts, and if you have multiple accounts, you can choose a default account, and that account is the one that's going to be using the signature, so keep that in mind. So that was an answer to a question. Another question that I get is how to find my car after I parked it. A lot of people know this feature is built into iOS, but don't really know how to activate it, so go into the Maps application extension in settings, scroll all the way down, and you'll see the show parking location. Make sure you enable that. And every time you park, then the iPhone will remember where you parked, and then you can go back into the Maps application and you'll see a pin that's going to be marking the location of your vehicle. So a lot of people didn't know how to activate that. That's how you do it. And last but not least, a lot of people find this annoying. Since iOS 9 was slide to unlock, everybody always keeps swiping, forgetting that it isn't swipe to unlock anymore, and ends up on this panel here, the widget panel on the lock screen. Well, how do you get rid of that panel? So in case you swipe to unlock, you don't have to just kind of get mad that you did that and just press the home button and go into your device. And what you want to do is go into Touch ID and passcode, enter your passcode. Once you enter your passcode, scroll down, and right here, the today view, you want to turn that off while allowing access on the lock screen. So now when we go to the lock screen, it won't swipe over to that section. It's no longer there. It won't annoy you any longer. So there you guys have it. That about brings it into this video. Hopefully some of these tips were useful. It's been iDevice Help, and I will catch you guys real soon. Peace.